Hello students, this is Subrata Ghosh. Now you will be learning how to calculate the standard deviation for a discrete series. For the discrete series, we have a separate formula. Okay. This is the formula. Root over summation f x square by capital N. Here N, summation capital N mean sum of f minus summation of f x by capital N whole square. This formula will be applied when the size of the value or size of the observation is very small. But if the size of the observation or the magnitude of the value of the observation is large, in that case we will use this formula. Here in this case directly we will put the value in the formula, but in this case when the size of the value is large, then we will find the d means deviation. How d will calculate? X minus a. A means assumed means, or you can also use the actual mean, but not necessary to get the actual value. You can get the near value of mean also. You can take this, will be applicable or will be applied in case of large value. Now we will solve the problem and we will see where these two formula is applied. Suppose this is the formula, problem one. Calculate the standard deviation of these two. Okay, see, calculate the standard deviation. Here size of the data is comparatively smaller, like 2, 3, 6, 8, 9. In that case we will use the first method, that is direct method. Okay, for that what we have to do? For that what we will do? We will make a table. Okay, this is the problem. Okay, so what is the demand of the formula? F x square and F x, it means we have to get the value of F x and F x square, and n is sum of frequency. Okay, now suppose one column will be suppose x, another f, one is will be f x square, sorry, fx, another will be f x square. Okay, what is the problem? 2, 3, 6, 8, 9. 2, 3, 6, 8, 9. And what is the frequency? 5, 4, 7, 5, 4. 4. Okay, now we will what is the demand of the formula? Summation fx square by capital N. N means sum of frequency. What is N here? Sum of frequency. N equals to 25. And fx, f into x, it is 10, 12, 42, 40, 36. Okay, this is summation fx, and if we sum it up, what you will get? It is, this is 140. Okay, what, 140. F x square means f into x square means f into square of this column. F is 5, is 5 into 2 square equals to what? 20. In this way we will get 36 is what? 7 square. Oh, sorry, x square means 6 into 6, 36. 36 into 7, 6 into 7, 252. 252. Then it is 64 into 5, 320. It is 9 square, 81 into 4. It is 324. Okay. Now again we will sum up this, and what we will get? 20, 36. It is 2, is 5, and this 952. Okay, now we will put this in the formula. What is the formula? Formula is summation f x square by n by summation f x by n whole square. Okay, we will put this summation fx square is what? 952. 952 by how many observations are there? 5 minus, it is what? It is summation fx is 140. 140 by 5 whole square. Okay, now if you calculate this, you will get the value. Understand? What first, what you have to do? First, you have to make a table. Okay, and suppose this is the table. One column, column two, column three, in this way you have to make a table. Okay, here you write calculation of HT. Okay, now if you take the value of this and this, then the value you will get, this is the result. Now this is the calculation. Okay, now if we put all these figures in the table, we will get this one. okay, it is the same table what I have calculated just now. X extreme left corner is the x, second column is the frequency, and this is fx, and the fourth one is fx square. It means x square into f, 4 into 5 20, 9 into 4 36, 36 into 7 252, 64 into 5. Okay, now this is the formula. Okay, I have put all the values from the table, and after calculating this, I have this value. This is the HD. In this way, you can calculate the standard deviation when the size of the data is small. But what is our second problem? See, calculate standard deviation of this. See, 15, 35, 45, 55, 65, 2, okay? Here, comparatively, size of the observation or magnitude of the data is comparatively bigger than the earlier one. In that case, we will apply the second formula. What is the second formula? Second formula was this. Summation fd square by capital N minus summation fd by capital N whole square. Okay, and d is the difference between the observation and the assumed mean. Assumed mean means any mean nearest to the mean value. Okay, now what we will do? Suppose to solve this problem, same thing. We'll make a table here. Now we'll see how to calculate this first. Okay. Now, first is x, then f, then we will calculate d, then we will calculate d, then d square, then fd, then fd square. We will make this 6 column. Okay, then we will put the value there. What is the question? Is the x is what? 15, 35, 45, 55, 65. Okay, x is 15, 35, 45, 55, 65. Okay, now sum of x is what? Sum of x is, I think, not required. Okay, now frequency. What is the frequency? Frequency is 2 4 3 5 6. 2 4 3 5 6. 2 4 3 5 6. 2 4 3 5 and 6 f. Now we have to calculate the d is what? Here you just take any value from here, or you can take the mean of this value, whatever you want. If you take the mean, then sum of this divided by number of observation, or from this value you can take any value. Assume mean, suppose assume means you are assuming any value as a mean. Suppose I am taking the 45 as a mid value, middle value of this observation. So d equals to, suppose, x minus 45. It is what? So 15 minus 45, minus 30. It is what? 45 minus 10, minus 10. It is 0. 45 minus 45, 0. 55 minus 45 is 10. 65 minus 45 is 20. Okay, it is n. Sum of n is what? If we add up this, we will get is 20. Now t square. 30 square. 900. 100. 0. 100. 400. Now fd. F into d. Minus 60. Minus 40. 0. 50. 510. 120. Then if we take summation of this, fd, fd square, f into d square, 2 into 900, 1800, then 400, then 0, then 500, then f into d square, 2400. Now f d square, okay? Now you add 63, 100, 120, 100, it is 70. Okay. Now 1800 plus 32, 22, 27, 51. It's 5100. Okay. It's 5100. Now, what is the formula? Formula is sigma equals to root over summation f d square by n by summation f d whole capital whole square. Okay, now f d square is what? 5100. 5100 by n, n is what? 20 minus f d, f d is 70 by n is what? 20 whole square. Okay, now calculate this value 5100 by 20 and 70 by 20 is 3.5 whole square. You calculate in this way, okay, and the result you will come, that is the result. Now if we make the fresh table of this problem, this will look like this. See, calculation of HD for the same problem. X is the observation, F is the frequency, and D is what? I have taken the middle value, 45. You can take any value from here, or you can take any outside value which is similar to that. It's called deviation, difference transport deviation. Here I have skipped one column. Okay, here I have calculated d square, but here directly I have made it fd, f into d, and d square is 30 square means 900 into 2, 800. In this way I have made this. Now this is the formula, this is the value. Okay, now value is this, just put this value in the calculator, you will get this result. Okay, this is the answer. In this way you can calculate the standard deviation for a discrete series or the observation having frequency. Hope you understood the topic. Next class would be on calculation of standard deviation for a continuous series. Till then, thank you.